Hey, come on in. Hey, everybody, it's a victory day. Come on in. God bless you. God bless you. Wherever you're tuning in from, zooming in from, chatting in from, wherever you're coming in from, come on in. Let me know. Let me take this off. It's a victory day. God bless you. God bless you. Come on in. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Absolutely. 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 Come on in. Hey, let me know where you guys are tuning in from. Let me know where you guys are coming in from. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. I see y'all coming in. I see y'all coming in. I see y'all come. It's a victory day. Hey, everybody, thanks for joining me. Let me know where you're zooming in, tuning in from. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. And it is Thanksgiving. Come on, give me that word, Thanksgiving. My goodness, that's what we want to talk about today, Thanksgiving. I know everybody, particularly in the DMV, is getting ready for Thanksgiving, but I want to talk about Thanksgiving. Come on, put it in the chat, Thanksgiving. That's what I want to talk about this morning. But before we do, hey, let's begin with a word of prayer. And the way we pray is the word ACTS. What is it? ACTS. The A has to do with adoration. The C has to do with confession. The T is Thanksgiving, and the S is supplication. Come on, give it to me. And don't forget to share, subscribe, and support. All right, that's the three S's. I know I'm throwing a whole lot at you guys, and it's early in the morning, but from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the name of the Lord is worthy to be praised. Let me know where you guys are coming in from. Put it in the chat. It's a victory day, Jackie. It's a victory, Linda. Michelle, it's a victory. D, we too, it's a victory day. I see you guys on Facebook, YouTube, and IG. Thank God for this digital space where we get to bring the word right to you. And this morning, it's all about prayer, prophecy, and practical application. That's my three P's. We are here till 7 o'clock in the morning. We'll try to shut it down by 7 o'clock so you can get on your way to work and get your kids off to school. But come on in this space. Hey, Nigeria, God bless you. Nigeria is in the house. Who else is in the house? Let me know. South Africa. I love South Africa. I love Nigeria. I love Maryland. Those are all of the places I have been. But I'm so glad I get to come to your place from my house. I thank God for technology. No jet lag, no running through the airport. I'm excited about the future of ministry. But thanks, everybody, for joining us. Let's go ahead and get into a word of prayer. And if you have any special requests, if you have anything that you need us to lift in prayer, go ahead and put it in the chat. Let us know. Put it in the chat. Let us know. Put it in the chat and let us know. All right. Put it in the chat and let us know, and we'll begin to pray for each one of you in a special way. And of course, we have been having some technical challenges, but God is faithful. God is faithful, and we are here today to pray for you. All right, put it in the chat. Anybody having surgery and need our prayers, put it in the chat today. Put it in the chat. Anybody else having surgery? Anybody's anything like that? Anything like that? Just put it in the chat. And we will begin to pray for you. Our Father and our God, we thank you for your faithfulness. We thank you for your loving kindness. We adore you this morning. Thank you from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. Your name is worthy to be praised. God, thank you for waking us up this morning, for those who just woke up. And thank you for giving us a good night's sleep for those who are going to sleep, particularly on the continent of South Africa. God, we thank you for how you've kept us for the last 11 months. We thank you for keeping keeping us for the last 19 months in the midst of this pandemic, God. We thank you, God, that you watched over us. God, we pray for those who are celebrating birthdays. If this is your month, put it in the chat. We pray for those who are celebrating birthdays, those who are celebrating anniversary. In the name of Jesus, we celebrate with them. You said in the book of Romans that we should rejoice or celebrate with those who are celebrating and to weep with those who are weeping. So God, on this morning, we take the time and the moment to celebrate those who are celebrating something. Somebody got a promotion. Somebody's got a job. Somebody purchased a home. Somebody got engaged. Somebody fell in love. Somebody got married. Somebody, whatever they're celebrating, God, somebody's celebrating a birthday. Somebody's just celebrating the fact that they are alive. But whatever they're celebrating, God, we celebrate with them. Now, God, you said not only should we celebrate with those who are celebrating, but, oh, God, that we should cry with those who are crying. And so, God, we pray for those who may be experiencing the loss, a loss of a loved one, a loss of a family member. In the name of Jesus, we pray that you will comfort them with the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit. We pray, God, that you will comfort them with only the comfort that you can give them, God. In the name of Jesus. God, we know it can be difficult even during this holiday season as many of us are thinking about our loved ones who were here yesterday and gone today. But God, I thank you that you know what it is to lose a child. You know what it is to lose a family member. You know what it is, God. And so God, we pray that you will comfort, God. Now, God, not only do we celebrate with those who are celebrating, not only do we cry with those who are crying, but you said in your word that we can cast all of our cares upon you, for you care for us. And God, in this feed on Facebook, YouTube, and IG, you see all of the people who are asking for prayer requests. God, I cannot read their name. I cannot read all of their names, nor can I read all of their prayer requests. But I thank you that the Holy Spirit, somebody put it in the chat, the Holy Ghost is moving up and down, even in this digital space, and reading everybody's name. Oh God, I thank you that you're going to meet Sister Diane Thomas for pray for healing, oh God, from sciatic nerves, God, in the name of Jesus. We pray for the children and the parents who are in school, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we pray that you will comfort those who need all the comfort that they may need. Father, those who are having surgery, in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, you can read everybody's name. I can't keep up with everybody's name. I can't keep up with everybody's request, but I thank you, God, that the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, is an ever present help in the time of trouble. So Holy Spirit, Holy Ghost, thank you for showing up in this digital space. Thank you for meeting us in our living room. Thank you for meeting us in our bedroom. Thank you for meeting us in our kitchen. God, somebody is driving to work this morning. Oh God, thank you for meeting them in that place in the name of Jesus. Oh, we bless you on this morning, God. Father, somebody doesn't want to get out of bed. They've had a difficult night. They've had a struggling night, but I thank you, God, that you woke us up this morning and that you are comfort to them in the name of Jesus. Strengthen those who need to be strengthened, God. Build up those who need to be built in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we thank you for our family. Somebody, let's get to the T. We thank you for our family. Give me the word family. We thank you for our family. We thank you for our faith. We thank you for our faith this morning. God, we lift. We thank you for our family. Come on, give it to me, our family. We thank you for our children. We thank you for our spouses. We thank you for our significant others, God. In the name of Jesus. Oh, we thank you for our family, God. We thank you that family matters to you, God. We thank you not just for our physical family, but we thank you for our spiritual family. In the name of Jesus. Now, God, we thank you for our faith. Come on, give it to me. Thank you, God, for faith. Because we know that faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not yet seen. We thank you for our faith, God. Oh, God, help us to hold on to our faith. Come on, everybody, put the word faith in the chat. Thank you for our faith, God. We thank you that this is our confidence. This is our faith that we know that if we, that you hear us when we pray. For you said without faith, manana seeking the romana, without faith, it is impossible to please you, God. For he or she who comes to God must believe, God. Oh, somebody put it in the chat. The Lord needs to know that you still believe. God, we still believe that you do miracles. We still believe that you can open doors. We still believe that you can supply our needs. Oh, God, we holding on to our faith. So we thank you for our family. We thank you for our faith. We thank you for our finances. Come on, somebody put it in the chat. We thank you for our finances in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we thank you for wealth. Hallelujah. We thank you that the wealth of the wicked is stored up and is being transferred to the hands of the righteous. Oh, God, we thank you that we're blessed, God, financially in the name of Jesus, that we're not stressed, but we are blessed financially. We thank you that our God will supply all of our needs according to your riches and glory. And so, God, this morning, we thank you for supplying our needs. We thank you for meeting our physical need. We thank you for meeting our emotional need. We thank you for meeting our financial need. Oh, God, we want to say thank you for meeting each one of our needs. Hallelujah. We thank you for meeting it pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Oh, we thank you for financial blessing. We thank you for bills being paid. We thank you for generational wealth. Somebody put it in the chat. Oh, we thank you for generational wealth in the name of Jesus. And then, God, not only do we thank you for our faith, not only do we thank you for our family, not only do we thank you for our finances, oh God, but we thank you for victory in our flesh. Hallelujah. Oh, you said you will keep us in perfect peace because our mind is stayed on you. And you said you want us to prosper and be in good health. Come on, give it in, put it in the chat. Thank you for victory in our health. Come on. Thank you for victory in our health in the name of Jesus. We're not thanking you just for wealth, but thank you, God, for victory in our health. Who am I talking to? Oh, God, we thank you that our mind must be stayed on you. We thank you that we will not lose our mind, but our mind will keep you in perfect peace because our mind is stayed on you. Oh, God, we thank you that you were wounded for our transgression. You were bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon you, and by your stripe we are healed. Somebody put it in the chat. I'm healed. If there is sickness in your body, come on, lay hands on yourself. Come on, lay hands on yourself. The Bible says, if there is any sick that is among you, let them call for the elders, and the prayer of faith will save them and raise them. Come on, lay hands wherever it is. You can put it in the chat if you want to. If it's your head, if it's your heart, if it's your stomach, if it's your back, if it's your knee. Oh, God, we thank you that you are a heart fixer and that you are mind regulator. Later, manana seeking it, and we thank you that healing is the children's bread. Come on, put it in the chat. What did I say? We said that healing is the children's bread. Come on, put it in the chat. Healing belongs to me. Come on, put it in the chat. Healing belongs to me. I dare somebody to put it in the chat. What did I say? Healing belongs to me. My God. Healing belongs to me. Come on, put it in the chat. Healing belongs to me. Hamanana sikende. Healing belongs to me. Oh, God, we thank you for your healing power. 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 Oh, God, we thank you for your healing power. That healing belongs to me. Come on, put it in the chat. Healing belongs to me. Healing is the children's bread. And God, whether you heal supernaturally or whether you use doctors to heal us, we thank you that ultimately healing belongs to you. In the name of Jesus, in the strong name of Jesus. Oh, God, we thank you for me. Meeting every unspoken request. Thank you for meeting every unspoken request. In Jesus' name we pray. Now come on, everybody, put it in the chat. Amen. Come on, give me the word. Amen. 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 Let's seal it with an amen. Let's seal it with an amen. Come on. Put that word in the chat. Amen. Say it with your mouth. Amen. Oh, so be it, and it is done. Hallelujah. Amen. So be it, and it is done. What's up, Lady Joy in California? Come on. Amen. So be it. Come on. Put it in the chat. Hallelujah. Amen. So be it, and hallelujah. What did I say? Amen, and so be it, and hallelujah. Hey, God bless you. Thanks again for joining us. Remember, we're here from 6:30 to 7 o'clock. We'll make sure you get out of here, but we always start off with prayer, and then I try to give you a little session, a little opportunity. And listen, I started a new series. The sermon is on your YouTube page of Victory Grace Center, and the sermon title is Give Me This Mountain. I need somebody to put it in the chat. Give me something big. Come on. Come on. Give me something big. Somebody give me the word big. Every time I hear the word big, I think about the late Joyce Rogers. She had me preach for her conference, and the word big in Joyce Rogers' eye was believing in God. How many of y'all are believing God for something big? Come on, put it in the chat. I'm believing God for something big. Come on, put it in the chat. I am believing God for something big. Somebody put it in the chat. Believing in God. I'm believing in God. And Caleb is the wonderful man at the age of 85. He asked for something big. Hey, listen real good. It's one thing to think big. It's another thing to pray big. Hello, somebody. It's one thing to think big. I can't remember the author of the book years ago. He talked about think big. But it's one thing to think big. It's another thing to pray big. Somebody put it in the chat. I'm not just thinking big, but I am praying big. Hello, somebody. I am not just thinking big, but what am I doing? I am praying big. Make sure you guys check that sermon out. It's on the YouTube channel. It's on the YouTube channel. It's gonna bless you real good. It's gonna bless you real good. I don't just want you to think big. I want you to pray big. That's what Caleb did. And Caleb prayed a big prayer. He said, give me this mountain. Give me this mountain. And my goodness, we're believing God. Who's believing God for something big? I'm so excited to talk to you guys about this amazing opportunity where we get to not just think big. Give me the word think big. We don't just get to pray big. Come on, give it to me. Oh my goodness. We don't just get to think big. We don't just get to pray big. Give it to me. Put it in the chat. Number one, I'm thinking big. I'm thinking big. Number two, I'm praying big. I'm praying big. I'm praying big. I'm praying big. You got to check the sermon out because I don't have time to go into it. But make sure you go on to Victory Grace Center. All right, Cynthia Brown, I love you. God bless you. Go on to Victory Grace Center if you can and check the sermon out where Caleb asks for something big. You know, and oftentimes, Pastor Cynthia Brown, and oftentimes, Pastor Bud, oftentimes we want God to give us something big, but we don't give back something big. Oh my God, my God, my God. You know, yeah. We think big and we pray big, but we give small. Oh my God, my God. So I've got something. I got a testimony. Somebody put it in the chat. Go ahead and testify, Pastor Jazz. I am believing God for something big. Anybody believing God for something big with me? Come on, put some hearts in the chat or put it in the comment. I am believing God for something big. Hello, somebody. I'm thinking big. I am praying big. And I am believing God for something big. I am like Caleb. I'm standing in front of a mountain and I'm saying, oh God, you have been so good to me. You've kept my eyes. You've kept me in good health. You've kept my strength. Now give me this mountain. Now again, I don't have time to talk about it. Y'all got to go check it out. But Caleb asked for what belonged to him. Oh my goodness. Remember, the Lord had promised Caleb at the age of 40 that this mountain belongs to him. 45 years later, Caleb is now 85 years of age. Oh, somebody put it in the chat. I'm not too young to pray big. I am not too young to pray big, Destiny. Nor am I not too old. I'm not too old. Let me talk to the seniors. Where y'all at? The 50 and over. You're not too old to ask for something big. And so, you know, the Apostle Ivy Hilliard, he's been blessing me me lately. Give a shout out to the Apostle Ivy Hilliard. And he said something common that I took to heart. And he said, it is impossible for God to use you to make something happen for others, and he doesn't make it happen to you. Oh, God, somebody say, please, Dr. Jess, say that again. Rewind. And I'm paraphrasing it. The Apostle Ivy Hilliard said, it's impossible for God to use you to make something happen for others, and he doesn't turn around and make it happen to you. Oh, my God, Cynthia Brown, did you catch that? LaWanda, did you catch that? It is impossible for God to use you to make something happen for others that God doesn't make it happen for you. And so I've been believing God. I've been believing God, particularly for our church, to acquire our own building. I've been believing God, believing God. Many of y'all know I pastored Victory Grace Center here in Bowie, Maryland. I really pastor Victory Grace Center globally because we don't have a building. Somebody put it in the chat. Not yet. Come on, put it in the chat. Not yet. Hello, somebody. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not yet seen. So we've been believing God, and we still believe in God. Come on, put it in the chat. We believe in God for our own building. Hello, somebody. We are believing God for a place where we can be able to house and do ministry. We believe in God. And this past couple of months or weeks ago, we had an opportunity. Somebody give me the word opportunity. Just give me the word opportunity. Dr. Younger, good to see you. Give me the word opportunity. Because I believe that we are in a season of opportunity, but many of you don't understand that opportunity sometimes comes with obstacles. Oh, Dr. Jazz, you are teaching real good. Wait a minute. Don't forget the three S's: share, subscribe, and support this ministry. Don't let me drop all of this bread and you don't sow back into this ministry. And I want to say, so sometimes opportunities comes in the forms of obstacles. Okay, a mountain can be viewed as an obstacle. A mountain can be viewed as an opposition. But how many of y'all know that sometimes mountains are simply opportunity disguised as obstacle? And so this lady in Trinidad, y'all know Trinidad, give me the Trinidad flag, give me the Trinidad color. This pastor in Trinidad and believing God to acquire a building for her students. She has 112 students. How many students? Put it in the chat. She has 112 students. And guess what the name of her school is called? The name of her school is called Victory. Somebody put it in the chat. The name of the school is called Victory. And she said in the middle of her prayers, she heard the Lord says to call Dr. Jazz and share her desire to purchase this building, which costs 4 million TT. Somebody put it in the chat. 4 million Trinidad dollars. Now, I'm from Trinidad. 4 million Trinidad dollars is a lot of money. $4 million is a lot of money. And she called me. And the moment she called me and I began to talk to her, the Lord dropped it in my spirit to sow 50,000 US. Oh my God. Somebody put it in the chat. I'm not just thinking big. I'm not just praying big, but I'm giving big. Y'all ain't ready for me. Put it in the chat. My goodness, the Lord laid it on our heart to sow 50,000 US. I need somebody to put it in the chat. Now, I'm going to show y'all a picture of the building in 1 minute, but here's the crazy thing. I'm believing God for building, Cynthia Brown, and the woman calls me about a building. And remember what the Apostle Ivy Hilliard said. It's impossible for God to let you do it for other people and he don't do it for you. My God, I felt the apostle spirit. Hello, somebody. And so we, my goodness. And listen, God told me, many of y'all know you've sown, and thank you for sowing. We've been believing God to get 1,000 computers to the island of Trinidad. 1,000 computers. Now, that was good, but that wasn't big. All right, that was good. 1,000 computers. All right, I thought that was big, but the Lord said, no, I want you to do exceedingly. Give me the word exceedingly. I want you to do, I'm going to do abundantly. I'm going to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all you ever ask or think. Hello, somebody. Who am I talking to? Who I prophesied to? The Lord said, I am going to do exceedingly. Give me the word exceedingly. I know y'all can't keep up with me this morning. I'm on fire. He said, I'm going to do exceedingly. I am going to do abundantly. I am going to do above all you ever ask or think. Y'all better catch this revelation. I'm not just thinking big. I'm not just number two praying big, but I'm giving big. Hello, somebody. And so I have never sown a $50,000 seed. Has anybody ever? But I've never sown a $50,000 seed. But I felt it in my spirit. And I want to say you made it possible because of your giving to Dr. Jazz Ministry. You made it possible. What did I say? You made it possible. Come on, put it in the chat. Because of your giving, not only are we giving 1,000 computers, but now we invested $50,000, not in property, but people. Put it in the chat. We're not sowing into property. We're sowing into people. 112 kids. Let me show y'all the building. Let me show y'all the building. Here it comes. My God, there's the building. There is the building that is going to house the next generation of prophets, the next generation of teachers, the next generation. Somebody put it in the chat. Oh my God, Facebook, y'all can see it. I gotta get it for IG to see it. Give me 1 minute. What did I say? We're not sowing into, no, we are not sowing into what? We are not sowing into property. We are sowing into what? Somebody put it in the chat. I gotta go get it, because my goodness, IG, you gotta see what your seed did. Come on, put it in the chat. My seed did that. Come on, put it in the chat. My seed, what did your seed did? Come on, put it in the chat. My seed did that. Come on, I need y'all to put it in the chat. My seed did that. Come on, I need y'all to put it in the chat. I'm coming, IG. Y'all know I'm multitask. Come on, I'm multitasking. Here it is. Hey, what y'all think? Oh my, nana, see, I got excited. I'm excited. Everybody excited. Look at this. My seed did that. Now that means you sold, right? That means you sold. And I want to give them opportunity. It is going to cost them $4 million Trinidad dollars. $4 million Trinidad dollars. $4 million Trinidadian dollars. And the bank, it's a private school. The bank has already secured that the bank will give them the $3 million, but they have to come up with $1 million. And so we sold $50,000 US dollars. And I want to give you the opportunity, because listen to the principle. It is impossible for you to make it happen for somebody and God don't make it happen to you. How many of y'all are believing for properties? How many of y'all are believing for properties? How many of y'all are believing for extra rental homes? How many of y'all are believing God for, hello, summer? I am believing God for $5 million. Yes, I sure did. What did I say? I am believing God for $5 million. Big! Somebody give me the word big. My goodness. And I want to give you an opportunity to not just think big, not just to pray big, but also to give big. Hello, somebody. And so the information of how you can do it is on the screen. That's right. The information of how you can do it is on the screen. Now, listen. Listen, there's two ways you can do it. You can just give that $5 million. You can just give that $50,000. Oh, my goodness. You can do like the woman, and you can give out of the abundance of your heart. Hey, listen, the information is on the screen of how you can give. I'm going to keep you posted, but I want to say thanks to all the Dr. Jazz partners who've been faithfully sowing $32 every month because of your giving. Hello, somebody. This has become possible. Thank y'all so very much. I can't wait to get to Trinidad to dedicate this building, to show y'all what it's going to look like on the inside. And my goodness, 112 amazing young people. 112. And you may want to sponsor a kid. You may want to sponsor a kid because it's a private school. They get no government funding. You may want to sponsor a kid in this thing. The Victory Academy that is going to raise up young people who are going to walk in victory in their faith, their family, their finances, and their flesh. I believe there's about 50 of y'all who are going to sow $100. I believe there's 50 of y'all this morning. The information is on the screen. That you have heard God and you want to partner with us and you want to sow $100. The information is on the screen of how you can do it. You may not have $100. You may just have $10. Whatever it is, come on, let's get ready to sow into some young people's life. Everything we give for the month of November is going to the Victory Academy. That's right, on the island of Trinidad. Look at God, on the island of Trinidad. And it is impossible. Somebody give me the word impossible. It is impossible for God to use you to do it for others, and he don't do it for you. Thank y'all so very much. Hey, my time is up. I will see you guys by the grace of God again. In the meantime, let's walk in faith. Let's think big. Let's pray big. And let's also dare to give big. It's Thanksgiving month. It's Thanksgiving. Father, thank you for showing yourself strong and showing yourself mighty. And thank you, God, that what you use us to do for others, you will also do it for us. I thank you that you're going to give us land. You're going to give us houses and property in the name of Jesus. God, help us to think big. Help us to pray big. Help us to live big. And God, help us to give big. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hey, God bless you all. Have a fantastic day. And thank you for your seed. Thank you for each one of your seed in advance. All the information is on the screen. I love you all. Be blessed. God bless you.